I appreciate the invitation. For me, it's great honor to be here. I will talk about work in progress with collaboration professors Phil Duxbury, Leo Liberty, and Carlile Lever. I divided my presentation in 7 topics. I will talk about our motivation. I will present again the unassigned distance geometry problem, the new models for the UDGP, our approach. I will present it, the computational results, some future works, and the conclusion, finally. My field is optimization. I have worked in 2 classical problems of the operation research, the good stocking problem and the sea port optimization. In 2017, Professor Carlile and Professor Weldon Loduck of the University of Colorado invited me to work then in distance geometry problem. Since then, I have tried to apply or to use techniques, tricks, models of the operation research in distance geometry problem. I will talk about now part of this process. Our motivation is to solve 2 real problems. Find 3D structure of the protein. Here we have some distance between hydrogen atoms of this protein. It's in PDB. This Brazilian group. I and Professor Carlile are working Dr. Caruso. Then it's one motivation. I will come back to this problem soon. Other problem that we want to solve is non-structure determination. Here we can see some distance of the C16 molecule. This is figure is in this paper of the Professor Duxbury et al. Professor Duxbury presented this molecule today morning. And I will come back to this problem too. Okay, this is our motivation. In this talk, we are in R3. Okay. Here, the small example of the assigned distance geometry problem. I will use an example to explain our ideas, our models. Okay. Then we have in this small example has 5 vets. Then we have 5 times 4 over 2 equal to 10 edges. And we have a distance for assigned for each edge. Okay? This is assigned distance geometry problem. Here the no definition for this problem. We can solve this problem, solving an optimization problem. Professor Liberty presented this yesterday. Such that we solve the ADGP, solving this problem, if X is a solution for the ADGP if and only if g of x equal to 0, where g of x is the objective function. Okay? This is a hard optimization problem. It's a non-convex objective function, but it's an optimization model for the ADGP. Okay. Here is the same example 1, But now we have a just number of vets, 5 in this case, and the list of distance. Okay? We don't have a sign between the list of distance and the edge. This is a small example for UDGP, an assigned distance geometry problem. Here is the no definition for this problem. We want to find a sign between list of distance and edges and the position of each vertex. We have two problems in one problem, okay? Our question is there an optimization model for the UDGP? Or is there a good optimization model for the UDGP? In the literature, there are two great build-up approaches. Professor Duxbourg explained for us today morning. The tri-bond, it's a deterministic build-up approach. And the liga, it's a stochastic build-up approach. I will talk a little about tri-bond because Professor Duxbourg presented today morning. Tri-bond has two main steps. Find a core. Remember, we are in R3. Okay? Then, the step two, the tri-bond algorithm, find a five click. After, this algorithm adds one vertex at a time. Okay? Choose 4 vertices in the existing structure. If step 4 doesn't work, we restart. And the output is the solution for our problem. Okay? This is tri-bond. I will come back tri-bond 2. Well, we want to create a model for the UDGP. Then we need assign this 2 vector. Okay? The vector here called D is the list of distance. Here, the vector called AD is the list of edges. In operation research, there is a classical problem called assignment problem that could be explained in this way. We have agents and tasks, and we need assign for each task, 1 agent, okay? In this problem, the optimization model has assigned variable, binary variable. This variable is equal to 1 if the agent I is assigned to task J, for example, okay? We are using this idea. It's very simple. Okay? In this example, let be A sub I j k equal to 1 if the distance dk is assigned to edge ij, and this variable is equal to 0 otherwise. Okay? Very simple. Then we need to work a set of constraints to show that distance is assigned at just 1 edge, okay? This equality assign exactly 1 distance dk to each edge ij. Here, for the example 1, okay? In the second one, assign exactly 1 edge ij to each distance dk.
So, for the second constraint, this would work if you have the complete list of distances.
Yeah.
If you have fewer, then you need less.
We are considering that we have a complete graph, okay? But if it's not complete, as it's less, it's inequality. Okay, thank you. Then we can now present the optimization model, the first optimization model. We want to minimize this objection functions, very similar to the ADGP case, okay? But now we are multiplying this square difference by the assigned variable, okay? Then we add this one if this variable is equal to 1, okay? Then we have the similar object function subject to the assignment constant. The variable x, x sub I in R3, the variable I, a, I, j, k are binary variable. Okay? Yes, we have a model, but this model has a big, big problem. Because there are a lot of binary variable. N squared times n minus 1 squared over 4. Okay? This is a big problem. To computational experiment, we are using the solver, Barrel, because it's a good solver, and because the solver, Barrel, it's branch and reduce optimization navigator. The solver solve mixed integer nonlinear program and non-convex optimization problem. Okay, it's our case. Then, using the software ample with the solver Barrel in my personal laptop, the example one was solved in 52 seconds. It's so-so, okay? But if the number of vertices increase a little, in this case, n equals to 7 vertices, there are 21 edges and 441 binary variable. The solver Barrel did not find a solution in 1,000 minutes. So we have a model, but this model doesn't work. Then we search an idea in topological optimization to solve this problem. Topological optimization, it uses this method, solid isotropic material with penalization method, such that the binary variable are replaced by continuous variable in interval 0, 1, okay? And the variable x in objection function is replaced by x to the p, where x to the p is x sub 1 to the p, x 2 sub 2 to the p, so on. Then this convergence of this method is described in this paper. Then we are using this idea. Here, our continuous model, I will explain why this works. We replace the objection function. Now we have this sum square. And the last objection function now is the first constant equal to 0. Okay? We have the same assignment constant, x in R3, but now the assignment variable is R interval 0, 1. Okay? Why this model is equivalent to the model 1? Let XA be an optimal solution for the model 1. Okay? Optimal solution for the model 1. An optimal solution for the model 1 is feasible for this model. Okay? Then we have a feasible solution for this model. We have this sum equal to 1. here. This is some court one. We have a solution for the model one. Are binary. The variable a is 0 or 1. 0 square is 0. 1 square is 1. Equal to 1. Okay? Then the sum is equal to n times n minus 1 over 2. Okay? Then we have this optimal solution. Then the optimal solution for the model 1, we have this objection form, this value. Consider now feasible solution for the model 2, such that there exists an unvariable a less than 1, greater than 0, okay? The square, this variable square, is less than 1, okay? Here, the square. Then the sum is less than n times n minus 1 over 2. Then this feasible solution is not 0 or 1, is not optimal. Okay? This is idea of the proof of this theorem. And then we have the equivalence between the model 1 and the model 2. Okay, then we are using the model 2 because it's continuous. But in model 2, we were very strict in the first constraint. We can replace the equality by this inequality, add the variable t. We want t equal to 0, okay? Then we want to minimize t. However, we want to maximize this. Then we want to minimize minus the sum. Okay? The last constraints are the same. Then you have this model 3. It's equivalent to the model 2. It's equivalent to the model 1. Okay? Then we are using this model 3. Yes, we have a new model. And the model 3 solve the example 1 in less time, 42 seconds. And example 2, 187 minutes. Then we think we have a problem again. Yes, if we increase a little the number of the vertices, in this case 10, we have 10 times 9 over 2 distance. Then we have 2025 assigned variable. And Baron did not find the solution in 1,000 minutes in my personal laptop. Oh my gosh. So again. Then we remember the tri-bond. Tri-bond is... Okay.
Don't you try to break the problem to small ones? So problems should be...
Like a build-up approach. Yeah. I don't know if it works. I don't know. Okay, but this idea is in tri-bond. Okay, tri-bond works very well. Then we new tri-bond. We put the model inside tri-bond. Okay, the step one. We find a corx sub 1, 2x sub 5 in R3, solving model 3, okay? After, from I equal to 6 to n, solve this problem is equivalent to model 3, but now we want to find one vertex. And we work in a random set with four indices for previous vertices. Okay? Then this problem is small because we want to find one vertex and we work for previous vertices. Okay? Like tribond, if it doesn't work, restart and try again. Okay? This is our approach, new tribond. We put the model, optimization model, inside tribond. Okay? For the computational experiment, we generate the labor instance, describing this paper, generate five instances for each n equal to number of atoms, n equal to 5, 10, 20, 50, 100, 200, 300, 400. Then it's artificial molecular instance. Here the number of solution found with time limit equal 1,000 minutes. This is number of solution found using the model 1, model 3, new tribond. Then when n greater than 5, just new tribond found our solution, okay? Here the computational time, average of the computational time in minutes. It increases, it's expected. I think it's good performance, okay? Because this problem is very hard. Then 400, almost 800 minutes, okay? I will talk about now two future works. The first one, in many cases, we have equal distance. For example, C, this C16 molecule, we have a lot of equal distance. Here, we have some one. Here, Professor Duxbury explained this today morning. If we use the model 3, and there are more than 3 million variables. But this problem has 21 in equal distance, 21. So it's possible work with 37,000 variable is less than 3 million, okay? To explain our idea, I use example 3. Again, this example, it's an artificial molecule. There are 18 different distances. We can represent this vector, list of distance, using two vectors. Here called, first one, dr. Dr is the different distance that appears in vector 3, okay? And the second one, here called n repeat, is the frequency of the each different distance. For example, the distance equal to 1 appears 9 times in this vector. Distance equal 1.68 appears 8 times, so on. Okay? Then we have a few number of assignment variable. Okay? This model is very, very similar. We replace 1 in this constraint by n repeat k for all k. The others are the same. The object function is the same. Okay? But we, in this case, work on a fewer number of variables. Preliminary computational result, using a new tribond with the model 4, okay? Example 3 was solved in 1.9 minutes, and C60 problem was solved in 40.63 minutes. I don't know if it's good or not. It's a preliminary result. My colleagues are seeing first time now. Yeah. The second future work, it's when we have interval distance. For example, this data is from NMR. All distance here are intervals. Okay. This, the third column, is the, for example, this distance of these two atoms, hydrogen, is 2.58 minus 0.832 and it's the center 5H plus this 0.832. It's on, okay? We have a lot of interval distance for when we work in NMR, okay? Again, I will use an example to explain our idea. Oh. Time fly. I finish. Consider this example with 5 vets. We have 10 interval distance, okay? We are using an idea described in this paper where we represent this vector using a function, a linear function. Then the vector, the distance, the interval distance d equal to d sub y, d sub u could be represented by function f lambda equal to d sub y plus lambda times d sub u minus d sub I lambda in interval 0, 1, okay? Then it's model 5. It's very similar, but we replace the real distance by the function f lambda. And we add the box constant for the variable lambda, okay? Another, it's the same. It's the model 5. And solved example 4. This example 4 was solved in 18 seconds. Okay, this is not new tri-bond. It's a model 4. Then our conclusions. We think it's necessary to make more computational experiments. It is a work in progress. It's necessary to compare our approach with tri-bond and ligand, and we wanna use the approach in real problems, nanostructure, materials, and protein. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions?
Is it more important to get a feasible solution, or is it good enough to get an approximate solution?
I think it's approximate. I think it's not good. I think. So it's Professor Phil.
I mean, an approximate structure is pretty good. Then you can use it as input for some refinement. It depends how far from the true solution it is. If it's on one of the different branches with a major difference in structure, then it's not helpful. In general, it is.
Okay.
Any other questions?
What's the complexity of the algorithm?
I don't know. I didn't study this. It's necessary to.
So you show the case for n equals 5 for interval distances. So will you try to work on the real NMR data?
For this example, no, I don't know. Okay. I don't. Yeah, okay. I didn't do.
So I had a question. Have you thought about having some small number of distances that are just completely wrong?
would that be possible to include in your model to allow yourself to ignore a small number of distances? I was going to ask you this as well.
Okay.
In the case of fullerenes, it works okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
In the case of tribot, we haven't tried it.
Mm-hmm.
You mean that the experiment provide an interval and the correct distance is out of the
interval?
Yeah,
it's just a completely wrong distance.
Completely, or just a wrong, yeah. So, you know, because there's a high multiplicity of the correct
mm-hmm.
distances for the fullerene, it's okay. But for a random point set, I don't know what it does.
Thank you.
Any other questions? If not, that concludes the second day. So thank you all very much.
Thank you.